there's this really weird high noise. And she said, oh, there's a bird right there singing. What? I had never heard that before, and that was amazing.
After living in silence, birds chirping was the first sound Julianne Bonta heard after getting her cochlear implant surgery. She documented her journey in a chapter of a recently published book, New Beginnings, Acquiring and Living with a Cochlear Implant.
I've been deaf, profoundly deaf, since the age of one. And then after I got the implant, how it took me years, and I'm still changing my experience, to learn to use an implant.
Bonta, along with the other authors of the new book, were panelists at a forum at the National Technical Institute for the Deaf on Friday. They shared the pros and cons of getting cochlear implants, hoping their stories could provide a guide for deaf or harder hearing individuals. The forum came right on time for Sally Skyer. She got her implant last week.
I was able to identify sounds that I've never heard before. Send an email, but I send an email, no bang. So I type email to myself, bang. And I talk to the email back and forth just so I can hear the sound. I loved it.
The implant consists of a microphone, a speech processor, and a receiver. It provides electronic stimulation to the nerves of the inner ear. The small electronic device has made a major difference in Skyer's life.
I'm understanding better. I'm understanding more. I'm now able to hear my voice. I wasn't able to for the first few days because I wasn't able to hear so much of my voice.
Cochlear implants have been available in the U.S. since 1984, and since then the technology has changed, and so has the number of people receiving the implants. At NTID, there was only one student who had a cochlear implant in the mid-80s. That number has jumped to 360.
My life without the implants would be, I can't even imagine. These things are like my life.
Reed Henning is a first-year NTID student and got two implants as a child. Even with his implants, he says there are still a few challenges and admits it's not for everyone. Some at Friday's forum say they had the implant surgically removed, but for others, the benefits have been life-changing. In Rochester, Jimmy's Price, Time Warner Cable News.